Beating Jordan 65-53. Copper Hills beat Layton 83-63 in the quarterfinals. Rod Zundel along with you and Dusty Lister back here. Dusty, I'm excited to see this game. Stockton Shorts is dynamic for Copper Hills.
Absolutely. I'll give you a report I got from Coach Evans, who was a coach at BYU Hawaii as well.
Ball is controlled and knocked away, and Stockton Shorts has it. Copper Hills in the dark gray jerseys and Lone Peak in the white jerseys. It'll stay on Copper Hill side. So Stockton Shorts number 12, Trevin Alfrey number 44, 32 is Sam Lyon, Callahan Blackham is 2, and Roland Bowman is number 3 as Stockton Shorts off the mark. That's your starting five for Copper Hill. Starting five for Lone Peak, number 12, Chantry Ross. 31 is Max McGrath. 5 is Max Brenchley. Nate Harkness is 35. And Stephen Ashworth is number 3, your starting lineup. That's number 2. That is Callahan Blackham bringing the ball down. And he's picked up by Chantry Ross to Shorts. Shorts is working on McGrath. Back out to Blackham. That's number 2. Yeah, Blackham. Got it right.
That's already has a last name for a first name.
Underneath the Stockton Shorts on the back cut. So Stockton Shorts up and in with the first two of the game.
I asked Coach Evans if he was recruiting Stockton Shorts at BYU Hawaii, what was his thing? He said he's a big-time player. He said he looks like a man already.
Harkness had a crack at it. Tosses it back out to Ashworth. That's Stephen Ashworth. And a little head bob to draw the foul there. And that foul will be on Blackham. That's his first.
3 years in a row, Lone Peak and Copper Hills meeting up in the state tournament. 2-1, the lead Lone Peak in that those 3 years. So it's really interesting to see where this goes. Stockton Shorts will have played Lone Peak now every year of his high school career in the state tournament.
Brinkerhoff working on Alfrey. Now he's going to hand it to Ross, Chantry Ross. And it's stolen away by Blackham to Shorts, and Shorts is fouled by Ross. That's first team foul on Lone Peak. Both teams with one team foul each. Coach for Lone Peak is David Evans. Of course, he took over for Quincy Lewis after all those years in state championships. Andrew Blanchard, the coach for the Copper Hills Grizzlies. Done a great job, and Stockton Shorts is one of the reasons why they've had such a great last 3 or 4 years working their way up to this, where, you know, they're considered one of the four top teams in the state. Alfrey with the miss, and Lone Peak comes away with it. Ashworth, and it goes off the hands of Brinkerhoff. It'll be Copper Hills basketball.
You know, Andrew Blanchard took over this program at Copper Hills that struggled a little bit. But you have a run with Preston Sanchez, Porter Hawkins, and a lot of these guys that played really well, Trevor Hoffman. And he mentioned Stockton Shorts, who's a year younger than that group. He's had a lot of time with them, and not only that, a lot of talent as well.
Ball stolen away by McGrath, working on Shorts, taking it right to him. Good defense by Shorts not to step to the side and pick up a foul. Three ball. Oh, what a tough shot. Stephen Ashworth. Lone Peak 3-2 over Copper Hills.
You know, Dane Stewart's mentioned time and time again on Deseret News Rewind that Stephen Ashworth leads Lone Peak in every category. Rebounds, steals, assists. He's second on the team in points.
How about that floater on the baseline by Shorts? That's not an easy shot.
No. Looked like his middle namesake, Carl Malone, falling away on that one. Is hitting that out of
Ashworth with another one. Air ball out. Shorts comes down with it. He'll take a three again. And it saved and off of a Lone Peak Knight. Who was that to save the Sam Lyon? Nice job from letting it go out of bounds. And he threw a dart at the ankle of a Lone Peak Knight.
That was a dodgeball special.
Lyon. Sam Lyon, the senior, on the board.
When you hustle, good things happen for you. Lyon saves it, and then he gets right back and hits the baseline J.
Harkness for three. Bodies hit the deck, last touch by the Knights. Timeout on the floor. 4:38 left. Copper Hills with the early three-point lead over Lone Peak here on Game Night Live.
At So Delicious, we don't just sell soda, we create your perfect drink. Come get your favorite drink skinny or extra dirty, or try one of our delicious desserts without ever having to leave your car. That's So Delicious.
4.5 left, first quarter. Copper Hills with a basketball and a three-point lead. Try to get it inside to Stockton Shorts, but stolen away. Here come the Knights. Chantry Ross back out to McGrath. Ashworth back to Ross. He'll reset.
It's interesting. I asked Coach Blanchard if it's a point of emphasis, get Stockton going early.
Chantry Ross with the early bucket, his first two.
Speaking of Stockton, a nice number 12 point guard hitting the bump, the jumper off the screen. But he said that Stockton can get it on his own. He said we don't have to run a lot of stuff for him because he can set it up himself.
Alfrey thought about the three. He'll take it inside, short arms it. And rebound on Harkness, and Alfrey's going to be called for his first.
Rebound on number 44, Truman Alfrey of the Grizzlies. Out of bounds, Lone Peak.
Copper Hills, two team fouls. Bingham, one. Ross with the floater. Alfrey hauls down the rebound. Out the shorts. 3.5 to play here, first quarter. 1 point Copper Hills lead. Shorts from 18. And he's short. McGrath. Blocked from behind by Sam Lyon. A couple of hustle plays here in the first quarter by Lyon.
And you got to have those, both teams. But nice job by Lyon going after and getting that block of McGrath. That's a guy. Max McGrath will make a lot of hustle plays. That's something you can say a lot about him today. He's done it all year for Coach Evans. And a fun matchup with him and Stockton Shorts on both ends of the floor.
Ball knocked away out of bounds by Ashworth. Pair of fives coming in. Ben Basinger for Copper Hills, and Max Brenchley coming back in for Lone Peak.
This is going to be a fun one. Max McGrath, he's willing to get down and play physical with Stockton Shorts. And he can't get any free ones.
Foul's going to be called on Basinger, who just checked in on the screen. Third team foul on the Grizzlies. Ashworth with the scooper. Stephen Ashworth has five. Lyon off the rim. Harkness for three. Harkness with the rebound and put back.
Nate Harkness does a lot of little things for you. He plays really, really hard. This team, Lompique, plays together. Harkness is going to go play at Westminster.
Blackham. He had a big fourth quarter with a couple steals on Wednesday to help Copper Hills pull away from Layton.
Well, Coach Schroeder told me that early in the year, he really likes Blackham, the way he distributes the basketball and how many assists he gets. He's a very unselfish guy and does a lot of things for Coach Blanchard.
Harkness working on Lyon. He falls down. It's not Harkness. That was Brenchley. Falls down and loses the ball out of bounds. 1:28 left here, first quarter. Copper Hills trailing Lone Peak by one, 9-8. Winner of this game will move on to the 5A championship game tomorrow, 11 a.m. against the Bingham Miners, the defending champs. We'll have that game for you, of course, right here on KSL and DeseretNews.com. Ball knocked away by Chantry Ross. Still Copper Hills basketball with 1:17 left, first quarter. Blackham, three ball, Basinger, no. Lyon again, tried to save it, but then it was saved by Harkness. Three ball, Ashworth, good. Stephen Ashworth, second three, he has 8 points. He has eight of the 12.
This might be a different looking Lone Peak team than what we've been used to the last few years, but they are so effective in what they do.
Off of Sam Lyon, couple of cracks at it for the Grizzlies and couldn't get it to drop.
Yeah, you don't see Stockton Shorts miss those very often, and Lyon had the putback and end up losing it, so double whammy there.
Final 30 seconds of the first quarter. Lone Peak with a 4-point lead. They have the basketball and working for the final shot. Stephen Ashworth with 8 of the 12 for Lone Peak. Where's he at? He's on the left wing. Let's see if Chantry Ross will penetrate and try to kick it to him or Max McGrath on the wing. There's the penetration. No, he kicks out to Harkness. And that is the end of the first quarter. Lone Peak 12, Copper Hills 8 here on Game Night Live.
KJAZZ TV, your whole high school sports. Remember, there are three new tutors broadcast Monday through Friday on KJAZZ TV, 8 a.m., 7 p.m., and 9 p.m. Thank you.
We begin the second quarter here, 5A semis for the right to meet Bingham tomorrow in the championship game. Copper Hills trailing Lone Peak by four, and Grizzlies with a basketball, and Alfrey's fouled.
This is going Harkness.
Nate Harkness picks up his first. Second team foul on Lone Peak. Shorts inside off balance, and he's fouled on the active shooting. And that's going to be Max McGrath, I believe.
Lone Peak foul on number 31, Max McGrath.
That's number one on McGrath. Stockton Shorts going to the line. He has four in the first quarter. He'll have a couple of freebies coming up here. Now he has five. Stephen Ashworth with a hot hand. He has 8 of the 12 points in that first quarter for the Knights. The lob pass inside to McGrath up and in for his first two.
And Max was a guy that the coaches knew, played really hard in practice, and he just shown up. I asked Coach Evans about him. I said, "What? Tell me about Max." He goes, "Oh, I love him. I love what Max does, and been very impressed with what he's been able to do here in his senior year."
Three ball, Basinger off the mark. Quickly down court to Shantry Ross, and he needed to have a 40 time of about 2.3. to catch up with that one.
A Bob Uecker line from Major League 2 came to my mind, but I won't repeat it on air. But no way he was getting that ball. That was well over his head.
Well, go ahead. Or is it not appropriate?
There's something about a rocket, but I won't go there.
Okay. All right. I can't remember that one. Alfrey blocked away by Brenchley. Quickly down floor. McGrath has it blocked by Callahan. But it remains and goes to Ashworth. They're going to get another crack at it. Harkness is fouled by Callahan Blackham. So for Blackham, that's foul number two. And that is the fourth team foul on Copper Hill. So Nate Harkness on the third attempt will earn a trip to the free throw line. Harkness with three. Garrett Frampton, the 6-foot senior, checks in for Lone Peak. Harkness makes both. He has 4 points. And the largest lead is 7 here with 6:37 left in the first half.
A 13-3 run, Rod. It was 6-3 early Copper Hills. And they only have 3 points since that point.
Bowman puts a stop to that run with his first bucket, a long ball. Cut the lead to 4.
He's a three-point specialist. If Lone Peak's not going to defend him, he could do that all game long to them.
Averaged 9 points a game for the 6'1 senior. Out of bounds, off the leg of Max Brenchley. So Copper Hills will get a chance to get a little bit closer here.
Biggest thing for Copper Hills is not to force anything. It's not part of their game. Especially for Shorts, not to force anything either.
Shorts working on McGrath. Up and under, going to be called for traveling. And he's called for traveling by the official clear on the other side and not the one that was looking right at him. Hate that when that happens.
That was either way it goes sometimes. Because, yeah, you're right. The one right there doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Harkness right down the barrel. And that dribbles in. Nate Harkness. He now has 7. It's a 7-point lead.
And that's why you snap your wrist at the top of your follow through.
Alfrey with a nice drive. His first two.
So Copper Hill's going to be successful. Alfrey's got to be one of the key guys.
Underneath McGrath. He has 4. Thank you. Bowman with another three. Back-to-back threes for Roland Bowman. He has six.
Said he averages nine a game, Rod. I'll bet dollars to donuts.
That's
they're all threes.
Timeout. For I was thinking that same thing. 9 points. I bet he has three threes a game. 21-17, Lone Peak over Copper Hills on Game Night Live.
At SoDelicious, we don't just sell soda, we create your perfect drink. Come get your favorite drink skinny or extra dirty, or try one of our delicious desserts without ever having to leave your car. It's so delicious.
4:48 left here in the first half. Lone Peak with a basketball 4-point lead over Copper Hills. 5A semis. Winner moving on to the championship game tomorrow to meet Bingham. That will take place at 11 a.m. Harkness, another deep three. Lyon comes down with a rebound. Sam Lyon's been busy. Nice crossover by Blackham. He's hit a couple threes here in this quarter.
You're going to watch Bowman. You got Ashworth now guarding Bowman, one of their better defenders on the Lone Peak team.
Nice cut by Lyons. Pump fake, up and in. Sam Lyon, he has four. And the lead is down to two.
Fitting gets the bucket along that baseline. That's where he's done a lot of his little things today, saving balls in, grabbing rebounds.
Moments ago, it was a 7-point lead. Copper Hills fighting back. Harkness, I don't know where the foul was on that. He got mugged on the way to the bank. Stockton Shorts along the baseline. We are tied. Shorts with seven.
You see the experience this team made to the state championship a year ago.
Again, they're hustling on the D. Ashworth comes away with it to McGrath, back to Ashworth.
But that experience, they didn't panic down seven.
That's not a panic. McGrath with his first long ball, he has seven. Three ball. Got another one. Roland Bowman now has nine on three threes. That's a season average.
65 triples on the year, Rod, including today. It's a big here for Copper Hills. You got a lot of guys. Shorts and create off the dribble. You got Bowman's absolutely rolling. Nice life for Coach Blanchard right now.
Roland Bowman has nine. Stockton Shorts with seven. Remember we were saying that Bowman's average of three is probably three threes to get his nine-point average? Well, he's almost there. A little over 2.5 threes a game. But it's stolen away, and today he has three. Ashworth, Alfrey with a rebound. Got to give credit. Officials are letting them play both sides. They're not doing the bump fouls on both ends. And the players are used to it. Alfrey for three. Looked good, a little too high. 2 minutes left, first half. McGrath for another one. Max McGrath, two threes here in the fourth quarter. He has 10 points, all of those points coming here in the second.
That hurts Copper Hills. Alfrey a chance to give the lead to the Grizzlies. And then Max McGrath, again, he guarded Stockton Shorts very well. here in the half. They now knock down two threes here in the final moments of the half.
Shorts around Brenchley and up for the layup. He has nine. That was a pretty good move to avoid the charge.
Savvy. Savvy working along the baseline.
Stockton-S. I'm never going to say that again.
If he was Malone, the foot would have come out.
You said that, not me.
I love Carl.
Wide open underneath is Brenchley. That's his first bucket. And it's a three-point Lone Peak lead. A minute left.
Beautiful dish from Frampton. Garrett just comes off the bench. Outstanding find underneath.
Out of bounds. Turnover. Lone Peak basketball.
Unforced error there from the Grizzlies. They haven't done that a lot in the first half. Actually played really clean. You mentioned they were down seven. Battle back here playing really clean basketball. And you talk about Bowman had 9 points. I mean, that was in about 45 seconds.
The three ball is off the mark by Braden Bromley, who just checked in. And we have a turnover traveling on Blackham. So Bromley comes right off the bench. Cold launches a three. Well, that caught Copper Hills napping, and Stockton Shorts are going to get the foul. As guess who? McGrath. He has 12 going back to the line, trying to make it a three-point play. Stockton Shorts with his first. That's a 9-0 run. Four seconds left. We got an offensive foul, I do believe. Yes, we do. And that's on Blackham again. That's number three on Roland Blackham.
Those are the ones I have a hard time with. After the pass, the charge, especially right underneath the hoop, no less.
So 3 seconds. Chantry Ross, launch a three. Almost got it. So we've come to the end of the first half. We have 16 minutes to play to decide an opponent for Bingham in the 5A championship game tomorrow. Right now it's Lone Peak 32, Copper Hills 26 on Game Night Live.
All right, fans, it's time for the America First Credit Union High School shoot-off. Here's how it's going to work. Each team will have one shooter and one rebounder. Our white team will be from Little Peak and the dark from Cover Hills. The shooter will have 30 seconds to make as many free throws as possible. The team that makes the most free throws in 30 seconds wins two $20 Visa gift cards, courtesy of America First Credit Union. So get on your mark, get set, and go. A slow start. In the white is Long Peak, in the dark, Cover Hills. It looks like our winner is from Cover Hills. Thank you for participating. America First Credit Union, where members come first. Today's game is being broadcast live on KJS in crystal clear high definition. Channel 14 on Dish and directed Channel 15657 on Govcast. Your attention, please, with the Springfield scorekeeper, please bring your book to the announcer's table. Springfield scorekeeper, please come to the announcer's table. Thank you. Your safety matters to us, so we have partnered with Zero Fatalities, the Utah Department of Transportation, and Department of Public Safety Program to help educate you on how to stay safe on our roads. Learn more at ZeroFatalities.com. Today's event is being streamed live online and will be available for replay at live.ksl.com. For over 50 years, Les Schwab has been committed to providing their customers with the most for their tire debt. Price, value, and selection at Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952. in today's first semifinal, biggest debate, Pleasant Grove 54-44. The Miners will play the winner of this game in the 5A state championship at 12 noon tomorrow. Starting the second half for Copper Hills, number 2, Blackham, number 3, Bowman, number 12, Shorts, number 32, Land, and number 44, Alfred. Starters for the night's second half will be Ashworth, number 3, number 12, Ross, number 30, Brinkerhoff, number 31, McGrath, and number 35, Harkness. Lynchlock Tucker Center's Tucker Junta State Championship. It will be Lone Peak's ball to begin the second half.
So Delicious is the easiest way to fill that sweet tooth need without ever having to leave your car. Whether you're looking for a Rocky Mountain High, you're just friends, or you feel like a million bucks, So Delicious has the perfect drink or tasty treat to fit whatever mood you're in. Visit one of our quick and convenient locations today. Learn more at tagyoursoda.com or find us on Twitter at SoDelicious.
We begin the second half here, the second semifinal in the 5A ranks for the high school basketball tournament here in the state of Utah. Lone Peak with a basketball and a four-point lead over Copper Hills. The winner to move on to the championship game tomorrow to take on the Bingham Miners. That's Nate Harkness taking it to the glass and off the glass for two. Matching the largest lead at 8, 34-26.
Be big here in the second or in the third quarter early on for Copper Hills. They got to find their offense. You had your moments. Here's Bowman, who had the three threes in the second quarter. You got to find some consistency, as McGrath has really done a decent, really good job on Stockton Shorts.
Shorts is fouled going to the hoop.
The risk reward for Stockton Shorts is the drive, is the charges, right? You're going to have guys stepping in front and waiting. But as he continues to be aggressive, he's going to pick up the fouls on Lone Peak, and the Knights are not that deep on their bench.
Shorts with 9 in the first half, 1 of 2 from the free throw line, and misses that one, 1 of 3. So Stockton Shorts and Roland Bowman scored both with 9. 12 points for Max McGrath in that first half. Harkness had 7. 10 points now for Stockton Shorts. Stephen Ashworth, he had a couple of threes in that first half. And a late whistle on the shot. Very late. Trevin Alfrey, number two on him. Both teams each with one team foul. Brinkerhoff. Jackson Brinkerhoff is on the board with one. So Brinkerhoff didn't start, did he?
He did.
He did start, yeah. Okay. And Brenchley came off the bench.
It's hard because the big men, you got Brinkerhoff, Brenchley, and Bromley.
And then Brinkerhoff went out early and Brenchley came on. Alfrey blocked, and a foul is going to be called on Harkness. That's number two on Nate.
Well, those are two tough fouls to start the third quarter for Nate Harkness. I think this one in particular. This is a tough one because he's there. If you're in defensive position, you can move. You have to stay in front. And I thought he did that pretty well. He didn't angle either.
His arms may have come down, and that's the trigger for the official to call. 3 points for Alfrey. Make it four. Lead back down to seven early on here in the third quarter. Lone Peak with the lead and the basketball. Stephen Ashworth, he'll take it to the hoop. Blocked away and a foul. Looked like the block was fine, but Sam Lyon may have got him with a body.
With the personal foul.
A strong take by Ashworth, and you know, you saw the angle. We were sitting in a pretty good spot to see that one. And I thought maybe Lyon would be able to get to it without getting to the body, but he did. I mean, just the angle itself, he got the block up top, but got him square in the middle of the body with his hips.
Ashworth with 9 points. He had two threes in that first quarter. Total of eight in that first quarter. Scoreless in the second. Got a point here. Got another freebie coming. Ten points for Stephen Ashworth. Lead back up to nine. Largest of the night for Lone Peak. Going right to Harkness. Bump, no foul. And out of bounds. And last touch by Lone Peak. Harkness looked like he had pretty good position. But again, the refs are letting him play on both ends.
And normally I think I'd say you got to call something there, right? He's there either. It's a block. It's a charge or it's a block. And just let him go.
Underneath the line, blocked away by Harkness. And even with two fouls here in the third, Harkness is still going at it pretty strong on the defensive end.
That's being self-aware, because Nate Harkness doesn't usually pick up a lot of fouls. He's a guy that usually will finish with two, maybe three on a bad night. And so he's very self-aware.
Shorts is short on the shot. Ashworth comes down with it, and he calls timeout. 6:07 left, Lone Peak 38, Copper Hills 29 here on Game Night Live.
RPG is accepted to be an official sponsor of tonight's event. When it comes to service, come to my shop telling centers. The stories you hear are true. They come in, you come in, ready and eager to serve you. HSTV is your home for high school sports. America First Credit Union or members of First Credit Union for high school championships on HS. Presented by Mountain Star Healthcare. Together we're greater.
Nearly 2 minutes gone by here in the third. Lone Peak matching its largest lead over Copper Hills. It's 9-38-29. Knights with the basketball. McGrath. But on the putback, it's Harkness. Excuse me, it's Brinkerhoff. He has three. And it's 11-point lead. Stockton Shorts, it bounces out. And Stockton Shorts got hit in the nose. And now they call an official timeout. Stockton Shorts holding his nose. He's kind of frustrated right now because he had a good look at it and it bounced out.
Man, that thing was three quarters of the way down before it came out. And I think also frustrated that it's just not rolling the way he wants it to go. But Copper Hill is right in its tough time right now, Rod. You're trailing by 11. These are momentum grabbers.
Harkness for three. That will keep the momentum with Lone Peak. Nate Harkness, that's his second three of this one. He has 10. And the lead is 14.
Every game gets that moment. You just have that feeling like one team's hanging on by a thread and the other one's right on the brink of doing something special. Right now, Copper Hills has got to find a way to stop what's happening in this ball game.
Shorts just bobbing and weaving his way in for two. He has 12.
Euro step at its finest right there from Stockton Shorts. Nice hustle by Blackham.
And then it's stolen away, and Chantry Ross has it over to Harkness. He just hit a three from there moments ago. He'll give it off to McGrath for three. Max McGrath, his third three. He has 15.
Coach Evans told me at the beginning of the year, this is about being five guys playing as one, and you're seeing it right now. Harkness had that three, and now Max McGrath with another.
And a foul out on the wing. McGrath, that's number two on Max. Actually, they only have Max as number one, so we'll go with that. Double team along the baseline. That was Bowman, and he'll have to call timeout. 4:12 left. Lone Peak stretching its lead to 15 over Copper Hills here on Game Night Live. Four 12 left, 46-31. Alfrey's fouled.
If you're going to look at a spot on the floor where Copper Hills has the advantage, and they've had it in the last three meetings as well, and that is in the post with Tanner Alfrey with his back to the basket. It's his game, and he's gotten stuck maybe too much on the perimeter. He can own this game from the paint if he chooses to do so.
Alfrey, 4-for-4 here from the free throw line in the third quarter. Three ball. Harkness. Couple of threes here in the third. He has 13. Shorts comes right back. He has 14. Chantry Ross. But Harkness hustling for the rebound. And but it's saved by Copper Hills. Blackham. He has four. Lead down to 12.
Good spurt here for Copper Hills. And right now, Rod, got to keep the defensive end, keep it going. They have to stay together. They have to play a lot of man-to-man, and that's gotten some open shots from Lone Peak with off-ball screens and movement. And they got to really buckle down on defense.
Ross over to Brinkerhoff, and he's fouled.
Great recognition from Brinkerhoff as Ross was able to get past his defender. It caused Alfrey to come down. Beautiful dish as Brinkerhoff was able to come to the hoop and now pick up another foul on Alfrey.
Both free throws by Brinkerhoff. He has five. Lead back up to 14. Three ball. Good. Well, that's big by Ben Basinger, who just checked in. That's his first bucket. Tried a couple of threes but in the first half, but this was his first.
You got a couple of guys in this team that could certainly do that, and we saw that in the first half. Needed a big moment, and it was Bowman that got him the first time.
Ross with a little scooper. He has four. Out of bounds. See who they're going to. Are there going to be a foul on Shorts? Yep.
Great defense by Max McGrath. Get his hand on that one.
Shorts with number two. That's the fourth team foul. Both teams with four each.
I mean, here's the difference. Coach Evans looking at Coach Blanchard thinking, saying, hey, if you want to play man-to-man, fine. We're going to spread you out and make it very, very difficult for you to stay in front of my water skeeter of a point guard.
Good one. And there is that water skeeter. How about that? Chantry Ross. He has six.
Chantry Ross looks at that defense and saying, I don't see Emmanuel A. Cotter in the guys against Wasatch Academy. He's already played this year and went right at him. Or Montverde or anybody else at Lone Peak's played this year. That kid, he's fun to watch.
Pretty nifty move by the 5'10 point guard. So now the official's checking something with the scorer's table. I believe they called a foul on Chantry. That's his third. Blackham. Blackham has six.
Biggest thing is, how do you respond? How resilient are you? And that's what Copper Hills has here in the final minute and a half. How resilient are you going to be? Because Lone Peak could push this right back up and make it a major deficit heading into the fourth.
Fouls on Basinger. That's number two on Ben. Fifth team foul.
Basinger, part two.
Chantry, nice play, but we got a foul on the dribble drive. It's going to be on Basinger again. That's a third.
He can't stay in front of Chantry Ross. No. I mean, that's a lot of court for him to cover, but he doesn't have the foot speed to match him.
Lob it inside to Harkness. Blocked, and a foul's going to be called on Bowman. It's number one on Roland. Harkness will go to the line, shooting a pair. He has 13. He's 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Those coming in the second quarter. Thirteen. For Harkness. 105 left here in the third. Lone Peak taking control here. Fourteen points for Nate Harkness. 15 for Max McGrath. Blackham had it stripped away out of bounds. Copper Hills basketball with 55 seconds left.
Copper Hills needs a bucket. A lot of times baseline inbounds, you can find some rhythm out of them.
Just like that. They didn't convert, but they get to recycle. Stockton Shorts. Three ball. Hit every part of the rim. Didn't hit the bottom of the net. We got a foul. It's going to stay on Copper Hills' end.
Bowman's wondering, why did Harkness get the bounces and I didn't on this rim?
McGrath. That's number three on Max. Try to get into Shorts, and I believe it's going to be Ross with a foul. And if that's the case, that's number four.
Number 12, Chantry Ross.
Chantry Ross with his fourth.
At the free throw line will be Stockton Shorts.
Fifteen for Stockton Shorts.
Checking into the loading lineup, number two, Garrett Frampton.
So Garrett Frampton will check in for Chantry Ross, who has to leave the game. He has 6 points and four fouls. Boy, you got to make free throws when they're given to you. Down 14.
He split almost every time at the free throw line.
Copper Hills wanted to travel, but it goes out of bounds, so it will be Copper Hills basketball with 36 seconds left. Andrew Blanchard saying, this is what a travel looks like, Mr. Official. And Mr. Official just put his palms up in the air and said, he didn't do that. I beg to differ, sir. And he's still letting him have it. There you see him at the top of the screen. Now going to work on the other official. Three ball is way off the mark. And there you see Andrew Blanchard still trying to explain to the other official what a travel looks like.
I wonder if the one official said it wasn't my call.
Timeout, Lone Peak with 25 seconds left. 57-43, Knights on top of the Grizzlies here on Game Night Live.
30-second timeout. A reminder to please remain off the floor following today's game. Please do not come onto the floor.
Twenty-five seconds left here in the third quarter. Lone Peak with a basketball and a 14-point lead over Copper Hills. And that was traveling. They got that one. You can credit Andrew Blanchard for getting that travel call right there after all the work he did on two officials. And that was the official that he was working on the most.
It's a game of adjustments, right?
Hey.
The obvious is never obvious to the oblivious.
Whatever you just said, I don't really understand that. I said it too quickly. So now, Copper Hills with a chance to cut into that 14-point lead with the final 20 seconds. Ooh. All right, it's up Stockton Shorts. He's guarded by McGrath. Let's see how these two go at it. You know it's coming. Now it's coming. 8 seconds. Shorts, you're going to head inside. Stop, pop, and rolls out. Tipped up and in. I believe that was Basinger or Lyon. Sam Lyon at the buzzer. He has six, and that cuts the Lone Peak lead down to 12, 57-45. We got 8 minutes to decide a 5A participant in the championship game against Bingham here on Game Night Live.
So Delicious is the easiest way to fill that sweet tooth need without ever having to leave your car. Whether you're looking for that Rocky Mountain High, your Just Friends, or you feel like a million bucks, So Delicious has the perfect drink or tasty treat for whatever mood you are in. Visit one of our quick and convenient locations today. Learn more at tagyoursoda.com or find us on Twitter at So Delicious.
Stockton shorts, Blackham, three ball, good. Callahan Blackham, he has nine. That cuts the lead to nine.
Nice job of shorts, not forcing it on that drive. It was inside out, 3-point opportunity.
Foul is on number 12, Stockton shorts.
Shorts picks up foul number three. That's the eighth team foul on Copper Hill, so it's free throws for both teams here on out. McGrath with 16. Brinkerhoff fights for the rebound. Took it right away from a couple of Grizzlies. Long three ball by Ashworth. He got it. Steven Ashworth, his third three. He has 13.
That is a shake your head triple. And what else do you want? Then he buries it.
Alfrey off the missed three, and he's fouled.
Now, Copper Hill's missed an opportunity. He's had a chance to clear that one out, just grab a rebound, and Alfrey couldn't get his hands on it. And it leads to that deep three, and he's got to make free throws.
Foul is on Garrett Frampton. That's his first. Alfrey at the line. He's 4-4 from the foul line. He has 7 points. He's 5-5 from the Freebieville. Six of six, he has eight. Blocked by Alfrey on Chantry Ross. Ross back in there with four fouls. And it got the Copper Hills crowd juiced up just a little bit. Now let's see if they can do anything with it on the court.
Chench Ross ate him up on the spread him out in the third quarter, so they put Stockton shorts on him.
And Stockton has three fouls, so he's got to be careful. Brinkerhoff, nice play by Brinkerhoff. Jackson with 7 points all here in the second half, 63-50. Stolen away. McGrath, easy bucket. Max McGrath has 18.
So Max McGrath having a big day, playing outstanding, and Copper Hill is just shooting themselves in the foot and can't seem to get out of their own way.
Brinkerhoff picks up his first, so we're going the free throw line here. Stockton shorts, and he has 1-1 coming up. He's 3 of 6 from the free throw line. Now he has 16 points. For shorts. 13-point lead approaching the 6-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. Harkness right down the barrel. Blackham comes away with it. Blackham over Brinkerhoff. Cal Blackham, he has 11.
What a finish from Blackham. I thought that was going to be a plus one.
Lead cut to 11. The floaters, no. Blackham with the rebound. They can get the single digits here around the 5-minute mark. That'll be pretty good. Give him a little chance. Stockton shorts. He has 19. The lead is down to 9. 5:18 left. Timeout. Lone Peak 65-56 here on Game Night Live. .518 left. Copper Hills has cut that Lone Peak lead down to 9. So trying to make a comeback here. Trailed by double digits most of the way. And Copper Hills was just kind of standing around on the rebound. Unfortunately for the Grizzlies, ricocheted off a couple of Knights and out of bounds. But Copper Hills just waiting for somebody else to make the rebound.
Well,
can't do that when you're trying to make a comeback.
Two missed opportunities because the defender vacated the lane, which allowed the layup as well. And so very, very fortunate.
Shorts and a foul. So we're going to see Stockton Shorts try to take this over right here. Probably.
He did the same thing against Bingham in the Utah Elite Eight Championship game, and Copper Hillsville just shortened that one.
McGrath with his fourth foul. So that's big. Two free throws coming up for Shorts, crucial free throws. He has 20 now. He leads all scorers.
Nothing's come easy for Stockton today, but you look at the foul situation, right? You got Chancey Ross with four. You got Max McGrath with three. Harkness has two. I mean, so you're right there, but a bunch of Grizzlies with three as well.
I have McGrath with four, but up on the board, they've got him at three, so I guess we'll go with that. The lead is down to seven. We're under 5 minutes now. So Copper Hill's giving themselves a chance. Let's see if they can continue or if Lone Peak will respond with something right here.
Here's the set that really hurt Copper Hills in the third quarter, spreading out that man-to-man, making him ISO.
And a foul on Basinger. I wonder if that was intentional, because it looked like going for the ball, or I'm going to foul, and maybe I want to send Ashworth to the line. But Ashworth is 2 of 2 from the free throw line, so I don't know if you want to send him there.
Now it's double bonus as well. Coach Blanchard, and I'll think, to answer your question, I don't think there was the thought. Coach Blanchard asking me, hey, just play defense, just stay in front of him.
Basinger now has four. Blackham has three.
And they were quick to the draw on the team fouls, so there are only nine team fouls. It'll be 1-1.
So Ashworth has 15. He's not the guy you want to foul. Oh, you got another one. So he has 14. He's 3 of 3 from the foul line. Now he's got 15. It's 4 of 4 from the free throw line. So the lead is back up to 9. 4.5 to play. Blackham trying to make something happen. So Stockton Shorts has it. Long three by Shorts, and that rimmed out. Alfrey going for the rebound, and bodies on the floor. Possession arrow if it's a jump. I haven't seen a call by an official if it's a foul or jump.
And no one had the ball.
Oh, there it's a jump. And it's possession arrow, Lone Peak.
I don't know that anybody had the ball here, Rod. Watch on the replay. I don't know that anybody has possession to call dual possession. The ball's behind.
There it is right there, yeah. True. We're watching a Jumbotron up here, the video board.
So it was an interesting one to have that call, because you think it would just be a foul call, but fortunate for Copper Hills.
McGrath went strong, and we're going to say Alfrey touched it last, but I don't know about that call either.
He didn't come close to touching the ball. That's either a foul, and you're giving the ball because you didn't blow the whistle on the shots.
I think that's what it is. Blocked away by Shorts, but we got a foul away from the ball. After all the physical play, and they call away from the ball. Roland Bowman picks up his second. Hopefully the officials don't start to take a different route here in the final 4 minutes. Harkness, he has 15. Both teams in a double bonus, shooting two free throws every trip now. 16 for Nate Harkness. Lead back up to 11. That's a big sequence right there. A foul away from the ball. Three ball, no. And the rebound comes down to Ashworth.
And here's a big one too, Roddy. For Copper Hills to stay in this ball game and keep the intrigue right now, defense. They have cannot give up easy buckets or easy fouls.
Okay, now, I don't get that. The ball was in the process of on the ground and being stolen, and David Evans for Lone Peak called timeout while the ball was on the ground, and the official gave it to him. Again, it's like the girls' games last week. I don't get that. The ball is in the process of being knocked away, and they call timeout. But give David Evans credit, because he suckered that official into calling a timeout when there's no business having that timeout.
Yeah, that's where the rules, you know, could change what they did in college basketball. The players on the floor have to call the timeout, yeah. And the coaches can't because of that situation.
That's right, because the ball was in the air and nobody had control of it, and the closest team to the play got to call timeout. But David Evans, smart, and the official bought it.
And he was quick on it, too.
He was. He was, because that was going to be a turnover for Copper Hills basketball.
Yeah, and if nothing
or at
else,
least a jump ball, which a possession arrow to Copper Hills.
That's just a smart play by David Evans. He knew he was going to lose it.
Boy, just a tough final last minute here for Copper Hills. But Lone Peak taking advantage of every opportunity they have. Steven Ashworth kind of fell down, and Basinger fouled out on that play. Oh, my goodness.
You know, and what you get when you go to the trap is a lot of movement, and that's a tough one. Basinger was getting away from him there as he went to the floor. But right now, Lone Peak, their two best free throw shooters hitting the free throw line. Speaking of Harkness, and now Steven Ashworth.
Basinger will check out. He had 1-3 in the third. So Ashworth going to the line. He has 15. He had a couple threes in that first quarter. It's 5 of 5, 6 of 6 from the foul line here in the second half. So Ashworth is not the guy you want to foul. And you look down here, from those who have shot free throws, Brinkerhoff is 3 for 3. Ashworth makes both, so Harkness is 6 for 6. I mean, this Lone Peak basketball team, they know how to finish a game off because they're a good free throw shooting team.
Like I said, it's not the team we've all starting to come to know from Lone Peak. These are guys very fundamental.
Count it. Stockton Shorts. He now has 23, and he'll be going to the line shooting for 24.
Never gives up, speaking of Stockton Shorts. Kid will keep going. He's going to go until he fouls out or the clock runs out. So he'll keep inching closer for Copper Hills. The big thing is they got to get stops. You can't keep trading buckets.
3 minutes left. It's a 10-point lead for Lone Peak. They have the basketball. Trying to finish this off and get to the championship game to take on the Bingham Miners. Harkness up and in. Nate Harkness, he has 18.
Field goal by Nate Harkness.
73-61. And we'll be going to the free throw line on the other end.
Number 32, Sam
Lyon. That's number 2 on Sam. So you can sense Copper Hills in that major desperation mode now. And you can sense that Lone Peak is saying, we got this, let's just finish it off at the free throw line.
And where you do it, right? Either you make the comeback at the clock stopped or you extend your lead at the clock stopped. And Lone Peak has been nails from the free throw line.
Brinchley, he has 3. Now he has 4, makes both. But I just don't know who you foul. I mean, It's just foul and hope, because Lone Peak, they are just finishing off at the free throw line. Alfrey, little scooper. Timeout. 10 points for Alfrey. 2:26 left. 12-point Lone Peak lead here on Game Night Live.
At Soda Licious, we don't just sell soda, we create your perfect drink. Come get your favorite drink, skinny or extra dirty, or try one of our delicious desserts without ever having to leave your car. It's so delicious.
Want to know the reason Lone Peak still is maintaining a 12-point lead? They're 9 of 10 from the free throw line this quarter.
Absolutely, right? Because you're not. There's never a difference in what you're giving up and what you're taking.
And Ashworth going to line again, and he's 4 for 4 here in the fourth quarter. 6 for 6 for the game. He has 16. 17. So 10 of 11. Sam Lyon will check back in. Steve Atten Ashworth, he has 18. Alfrey had a foul. It's going to be on Ashworth. That's only the first on Ashworth. As much traveling as he's been doing up and down this court. Alfrey has 10. 11. Speaking of good free throw shooters, he's 7 for 7, all here in the second half. Of course.
The jinx game.
Harkness, what a game he's had. 18 points. And Sam Lyon got hit in the nose. And now Lone Peak says, what? That's the only thing they've done wrong here in the second half.
Coach Evans is pretty much beside himself saying that ball went off of Stockton shorts. And if I were Coach Blanchard, I'd say, well.
It went off of Stockton shorts?
That's what he said. Yeah, they said it went off his foot.
It went off his shorts?
Holy cow. How did I not see that?
I know. I've been waiting all game.
The obvious is never obvious to the oblivious.
How about shorts splitting the defenders and eluding the defender for two more. 25 for Stockton shorts. Two above his average. Stolen away, picked up. Three ball. Boy, that would have been big. Ashworth is fouled, and he'll be going to the line. You know, good hard foul.
A frustrating day from the field for Stockton shorts. Almost like he doesn't have his legs today on his three-point shot. Everything's been short and well short.
He hasn't hit a three.
Mm-hmm. I think about 0 for 4, 0 for 5 from deep, but all of them, he had a couple air balls, but all of them off the front of the iron.
Nineteen for Ashworth. 7 for 7 from the free throw line in the fourth quarter. 9 for 9 in the second half from the charity stripe. He has 20. Running out of room for free throw lines on my stat book. 13-point lead, a minute and a half left. Three ball up, and it is good. Roland Bowman, that's his fourth three. He has 12. Timeout Grizzlies, 1:25 left. The lead is down to 10 here on Game Night Live. 10-point lead for Lone Peak. 1:25 left. Knights with the basketball. Who are you going to foul?
Oh! Oh, what a collision.
You know, we don't have a four on our roster.
Seth Parker?
Seth Parker and maybe Mr. Jeff Sid Argyle, but.
I heard Parker and you heard Argyle. That's pretty bad. That's a collision with McGrath, though. Whoa.
And I think he's going for the ball,
oh,
too,
yeah.
Right?
And McGrath just turned and it was bam. How's that for McGrath to come back? He has 19.
And Max's dad, McKay, one of the star players at the University of Utah years ago.
Oh, that's McKay's kid?
Yes, sir.
Oh, McKay was awesome.
Proud papa watching his boy Max have an outstanding senior year.
And Max is 3 of 4 from the foul line here in the fourth quarter. It's a 12-point game. Stockton Shorts, his career coming to an end. But what a career it's been, huh?
This week alone, right? He's getting a lot of national attention. Max Preps writing the articles. You have the Dan Patrick Show talking about him. And
if they'd have just watched KSL Channel 5 2 years ago, they would have known this already.
Absolutely. And I thought the same thing when I saw him. Like, how do you – anybody local that didn't know that?
No, we did the story when he was a sophomore.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, one of the great things about Stockton Shorts is his ties to Carbon County. His grandfather from Wellington, like someone else on this broadcast. And
Max McGrath comes out, 20 points. Stockton Shorts, 2 free throws. He has 26.
But what a senior year for Stockton Shorts. He started all 3 years.
Yep.
And been a leading scorer in 5A. That's some memorable, memorable moments.
Yeah, average 23 points a game. Harkness, let's see if they play it straight up or if they're going to foul and stretch it out longer. Guess we got our answer.
Hoping to find someone's going to miss, right? And then hit the three, see what you're going to get. So the last, 4 minutes has taken probably lifetime, real time of, 15? And
mm-hmm.
So
three fouls on Bowman, yeah. Brenchley's 3 for 3 here in the fourth quarter. Four for four. Boy, it's tough to beat somebody when you're trying to get them to miss and they just don't. I mean, they missed one free throw here in the fourth quarter. And a quick foul.
You know, and for Lone Peak, I shared the stat earlier, going back, and actually you can go back to Jackson Emory, when they won the state championship in 2005, there has not been a senior class at Lone Peak to not win a state championship basketball, a championship in basketball.
Uh-huh.
They've never had a blink for 3 years in a row since then.
So Brenchley again, he has 7. 19 for 20 free throws in the fourth quarter. Brenchley with 8. Stockton. You know he wants to hit a 3 to end his career here. Down to Brenchley. Laying up and in. He has 10. 87-71.
You know, Rod, we're talking about at the break, we're going to have a rematch of the football championship, Lone uh-huh. Peak and Bingham.
Bingham winning the football title. Chantry Ross fouls out. Or no, he checks out. 6 points. But he had a lot more important than that.
Absolutely.
So out comes Sam Lyon, out comes Callahan. both seniors. Let's see if they're going to try to get Stockton Shorts out to an applause as well as he misses the first free throw. He has 27 points. And that rolls off. I think they're going to foul. Yeah, they do, so they can get Stockton Shorts out of there. He'll pick up number four. So there you see one of the greatest names in Utah high school basketball history. One of the greatest careers as well, number 12, Stockton Shorts. Taking a seat for the final time in his career. To a nice round of applause, basically by both schools. So Stockton Shorts leaves with 27 points. Boy, it's just tough to see your high school career coming to an end knowing that you're not going to play with these guys again. That's a tough thing to handle, but boy, what a career these guys have had together.
On the most successful time of Copper Hills basketball. You go to a state championship game, which I hadn't been to, and now to get to the semifinals and what his 3 years has brought. Lost in the first round, got to the championship and semifinals. Mm-hmm. That's the best three-year run at Copper Hills.
Ashworth just missed his first free throw. Now he's like 30 for 31 here in this game. Not quite, but close. He has 21.
20 of 22 in the quarter.
20 of 22 here in the second quarter or fourth quarter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of 10. 11 of 13 for Ashworth in the game from the free throw line. Tipped up and in.
We're below our roster depth.
Parker Rollins, the senior, getting in. That's it. The Lone Peak Knights, 88-73. It's Lone Peak and Bingham tomorrow for the 5A championship, 11 a.m. right here on KSL and DeseretNews.com. We're going to be back with the 4A semifinals. First up, it's Hillcrest and Springville. Then it's Corner Canyon and Olympus right here on KSL.com and DeseretNews.com. So it's a great career comes to an end for Stockton Shorts and the Copper Hills Grizzlies. What a year they had. They finished 21-5. Lone Peak moves on to the title game. 4A coming up next to determine the participants in tomorrow's 4A title game. We'll have that for you coming up in about 10 minutes right here on KSL and DeseretNews.com.